far as we know, when we collide two elementary particles together, one of the possibilities that can happen is that different particles come out of that collision than went in. So you could have two protons that come together, collide, and out of that could come many pions, an electron, a photon, and a muon. And it's not as if those particles were somehow trapped inside the proton or even rearranged. They're fundamentally different particles that come out of the collision. So it would be like if you were watching a car collision, and instead of two cars coming together and two cars being the output of the collision, the two cars came together, collided, and a kitchen sink and a chair came out. Now, we've always heard this analogy of it's looking for a needle in a haystack, but it's not just the needle in the haystack that you're looking for, but it's a needle in 100,000 or a million haystacks, right? You don't even know which haystack you should be looking at to begin with. And so how to choose which one and how to find that thing in the most efficient way possible, you really have to be very clever and really push the boundaries of technology.